What's playing Jim and Chuckfinlers play Spyro, Year of the Dragon, Part 11. We are here and in front of the rocket, and now we're going to go fight Spike, the boss for this particular level. You can see a monster to end all monsters there. So I guess this is where they're going to make Spike. Well, actually,
that's it. I've had enough. I'm going to create a monster to end all monsters. And I'm going to send it out to destroy all the dragons, even the little hatchlings. Yes, yes, it will smash them and crush them and grind them and tear them. Oh, yes, smear them and smoosh them and crack them and crease them.
Won't that kill them?
It doesn't matter, as long as I can still collect their wings.
What? All this time you've only wanted them for their wings?
Of course, you ignorant girl. I need them for a spell, so I can live forever.
Wait a second. A spell?
What did you think I was going to do with all those dragons? Open a zoo?
You said just keeping them in our world was enough. You never said you had to kill them.
I don't have to kill them. It just stops them from wriggling so much.
You're terrible. I can't believe I ever listened to you.
Stupid, insolent brat. I'll take care of her as soon as I finish off that dragon. Now, where was I? Ah, yes!
So it doesn't seem like we get to actually see Spike being made this time, but because this is the third boss, it will probably be pretty difficult.
This might be our last stand, Spyro. The sorceress plans to use this monster to destroy every iota of her opposition, beginning with the two of us. Alas, there is no time for ruminating. A battle awaits us. I will endeavor to assist you by means of a steady provision of combustible projectiles.
So, he is a flying enemy. And it looks like he uses a lot of the same attacks that Ripto used, as a matter of fact. So, that's probably a shield, so we're not going to be able to attack him while... Oh, crap. I didn't notice the crabs there. Alright, so that's what the red ones do. They're a bunch of little rockets. That appear to be pretty effective if you can make sure that you hit Spike. Oh. Yeah, I'm pretty sure his name's Spike. I may be calling him the wrong thing. Okay, so I guess he can kill the crabs as well. Let's make sure we. Ah. Oh wow, I didn't expect them rats to be there. Oh, we have to be careful. I heard the rats, but I thought that was what was coming out of that rocket. But those don't seem to be able. I guess you're supposed to. Oh, those are actually pretty effective. The green ones. But now I'm without sparks. Yeah, so I definitely suggest trying to go after the green ones as much as possible. Those seem to be able to do a lot more damage than the... Oh, what the... I wonder if he'll blow himself up. Yeah. But you can see, you can probably use the red ones... a little bit more effectively. What the? Watch out for that. I wonder what happened to him. Alright, I want to get the... No. Crap. Should have been more careful, but I know what to do now. I know what to expect, so I shouldn't take that much damage. I'll probably take a little bit, but I shouldn't take a whole bunch. Cannot believe I missed that rocket that many times. Sadly, it doesn't appear that these rockets are of the homing variety. So that makes it a little bit more difficult to hit him with them. Oh, you can actually stop him from attacking. That's useful. Make sure to watch out for the rats. They are very fast. A lot faster than I thought they would be. I didn't think they could keep up with me. Oh, I guess that broke on that egg. Wow, I did not expect them to be able to keep up with me like that. That still hit him, thankfully. But now I'm down pretty low. I've only got one spark now. So definitely want to be very careful. Oh, crap! Ah. Probably drop Buzz next. Yep. I'm sure that's Buzz, yep. So it's a boss fight within a boss fight, but thankfully he's pretty easy. He'll drop just another Buzz. Thankfully, he's pretty easy to get rid of. A lot easier than I expected. Oh, crap. Crap. Missed another one of you, huh? Still no sparks. What the? I'm sure I still could have died if I hadn't dodged the fireball, so that you do want to be very careful about something like that. Oh, but yeah, not a very difficult boss fight. It is a little bit, but not a whole bunch, so thankfully it makes it a little bit easier, but now hopefully Hunter will be freed so I can go back and redo those levels.
Hi, Bianca. Did you bring any more food? I'm starving.
There's no time for that, Hunter. We have to stop the sorceress. She's gonna kill all the dragon hatchlings.
Wait a minute. Why should I trust you? This could be another trap.
You're in a cage, you furry numbskull. How can I trap you by letting you out?
I don't know. You sorceress types can be sneaky.
We don't have time for this.
Alright, so this is the new homeworld, Midnight. I don't remember Midnight something. I don't remember the name of it, to be honest. But we're not going to do anything in here. Hunter should... Well, I almost kind of want to look for Hunter really quickly before... Hopefully she will tell me.
Spyro, I know you don't trust me, but I want to help you stop the sorceress. There's a way to open a hidden portal to her lair, but it'll take some very strong magic. If you can find more of the dragon eggs, I think my magic will be strong enough to open the portal. I'll come find you when you have enough eggs, okay?
Alright, so... I hope that's Hunter freed. So, even... Oh, okay, Scorch. My bad. I guess I kept seeing the previous boss. So, we'll head to the previous world, and if nothing else, we can at least do the sparks areas. I'm not sure if Hunter will be free or not, but I hope so. But we'll go ahead and fill back up on sparks really quickly. And I don't remember exactly... Okay, good. Wasn't sure exactly where this was.
Princess Amy showed me a place called Starfish Reef. She says there's an egg hidden in there. I think Spark should check it out.
Okay, so... just like everything else, this is going to be a lot harder than the previous two. I don't remember by how much, though. I mean, you can see it's underwater. It doesn't really matter. Oh crap! It doesn't matter if the bubble cannot be popped, so it doesn't matter. You don't have to worry about potentially losing air with it. You know, you can see the butterflies also have bubbles on. You know, it's just, I guess, because dragonflies and butterflies can't breathe underwater. You can see there's starfish as well as, I believe, another type of fish there. I don't know. I kind of killed him a little bit too fast. But you can see what these starfish come out of. Just want to be careful so you don't end up missing any treasure. Just, these are big starfish that blow up into a little starfish. A little fast-moving starfish, too. We'll save him for later. I'm sure I will be able to come back. At least I hope I will be. That's not open right now. Oh. Okay. Well, I'll go ahead and grab him since I doubt I'll be back. I'll be coming back this way. Didn't mean to grab that, but oh, okay, so these things shoot fire at us and they block our path. Ah, crap. Bomb's actually pretty useful. Sadly, you can't charge into the enemies to damage them. You only have, the only way you can damage them is by shooting them. That would definitely make it a lot easier if you could. Shoot them or charge into them. So that's a checkpoint, thankfully. I hope that door at the beginning of the level I didn't mess me up, but I should still be able to go back there if I need to. Oops. Oh, crap. Ah. Wow, I need a butterfly bad. Oh well. The only thing I do is just lose my ability, and I wasn't even using it that much to begin with, so it doesn't really matter. I'll just try to stay on the move a little bit more and see if we can knock out a lot of these starfish a little bit earlier. Ah, crap, went the wrong way. What the? bomb again. Man, these starfish are fast, the little ones. Alright, we'll take this a little bit slower this time. I won't just charge in ahead like I was doing before. Now I'll try to stay at the top. Sadly, you cannot shoot and charge at the same time. That would definitely make, like, dealing with a bunch of these starfish a little bit easier. Strafing definitely helps, especially for faster enemies. With these fish, you will have to strafe. So, you're gonna have to learn how to, just because it makes finding them a little bit easier. I guess that's what makes them continue to come back. So we'll go ahead and knock him out real quickly. Takes about three hits to knock out the fish, so you do want to keep that in mind. You gotta be careful and be ready because of all the starfish there. Probably a... Oh. Figured there would have been a... I'm going to train out power-ups. I like the spray of bullets better. That should help me out more, especially with a bunch of... Oh, crap. Like this. You just hide in a corner, or you could and try to knock their numbers down a little bit and then just hit them head-on with your single shot. Like something like this, you know, you... Of course, you want to be careful and pay attention to where the starfish are, but it definitely helps trying to clear out like a whole bunch of these starfish that may appear. Maybe it's only two, but it's either two or three bullets take out the fish. So you really don't have to worry about the fish all that much. Make sure there's nothing else here. I don't think there is. So we'll just keep going. Thankfully, they let you. If you can get yourself in between the door and between the doors, it won't close on you, and that will allow you to run if you need to. But yeah, you just see how useful the green butterfly is against a crowd of these small types of enemies. You know, the small crawdads or the small spiders. Or whatever, you know, whatever, like that. Little things like that. It definitely makes it a lot easier to go after. So we still got quite a bit of our special ability. I believe this is the boss room. Usually whenever you see a golden treasure in a room, in a wide room like this, that usually means that there's treasure here. Ah, crap. Ah, he hurts quite a bit. And he keeps moving. That's never good. And he shoots bombs. Again, not very good either. Ah, wow. Didn't expect him to be there. Special ability, but I really wasn't. pattern that he follows kind of appears like it. So if you can remember the pattern, that may help. Now he splits up into two, great. Two small ones that spit out a bunch of little ones that they can back you up into a corner, and I wish I had the green butterfly. That would definitely help right now, clearing out the small ones. This ain't too bad. There you go. I'm not even gonna attempt to pronounce that name. Alright, so we'll bypass that. We'll head down into this door, and hopefully this will give us the last of the treasure. And we'll reveal that this was the door at the beginning of the level. Okay, good. So, I guess this level loops around most of these Sparks levels don't loop around. I'm not sure that every single one doesn't, but I know the previous two levels didn't. So I guess it was supposed to be like a mystery door that you think about the entire level, and then you, at the end, realize that, that was the door that was at the end of the level. But anyway, so I want to check out Honey Speedway really quickly, just to make sure that that's Bentley's Outpost. Let's see, where's Charmed Ridge at? I want to check out Honey Speedway really quickly, because that'll be a little bit easier than traveling all the way through Lost Fleet to figure out whether or not Hunter is back. I'll still do Lost Fleet, regardless, but it's just a little bit easier for me to go into Honey Speedway to check out if Hunter is back. Like I said, to do that. So we'll just go to the Time Attack Challenge. And I kind of remember where Hunter is now. I believe he is around the honeycombs, if I'm not mistaken. He may have been along the bee trail, but I believe all I have to do is just follow the honeycombs, and I should be able to find him pretty easily. And if nothing else, I will just follow this route, and I should see some sign of him. Yep, there he goes.
Look out, Spyro. There's a really big sheep UFO around here, and it's trying to get me. I snatched up a dragon egg it was trying to abduct, and now it wants revenge.
Oh, I'm sorry. You wait here. I'll lure the UFO down the river of honey. I thought it was gonna say this.
Okay, here I go.
Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to control Hunter. You can see you can jump quite a ways, and I believe all you have to do is just make sure that the UFO does not catch you. It does not appear that I can speed up at all. And it would appear that the UFO is gaining on me, and I'm sure hitting things will slow me down quite a bit.
Look out, Spyro.
Okay, so we're just gonna keep.
You wait here. I'll lure the UFO down the river of honey.
Alright, so we'll just keep doing it. I know what to do now. I should know what to do now. I don't think jumping will slow you down. It's just hitting stuff seems to be the only thing that slows you down quite a bit. At least I hope jumping doesn't slow you down, because if it does, that kind of stinks. That's the only way I can defend myself against all the obstacles. It would appear that the UFO tries to gain on me, but if I jump in the air, he kind of stops to avoid colliding into me. Crap. And sadly, you can't skip this. But it's just It's just remembering the pattern of the obstacles along the route and trying to dodge them. I don't believe you can actually dodge the logs. It kind of looks like you may be able to slip in between the logs and the wall, but I don't think you can. There does not appear to be a small hop. There's only this gigantic leap that you can do. And so that... What the? Well, how in the world are you supposed to defend against that? Okay, well, perhaps I can try. Ah, crap. It seems if you hold the X button down, you can stay in the air longer, so that may help. But there is no small hop. I'm not even sure what I did there. You see, there's no way you can defend against that if the sheep gets in front of you.
Look out.
I'll just try it again. I'll see if I can fit in between the wall and the log. No, I didn't think so. That's about as short a hop as you're gonna get, to be honest. Outside of just jumping like crazy, I don't see any way you can defend yourself. If the UFO gets in front of you, there's no way to speed up or slow down. The only thing you can do is just jump or move left and right. Avoiding a lot of the rocks will help. Trying to avoid as much of the logs as you can as well. That will definitely help, but you know, if you can't avoid the logs, really, this is a tough challenge. Yeah, there doesn't seem to be anything else I can do outside of just jumping. Come on. What the?
Look out.
Bad thing is they don't let you jump really fast right after you land. They don't let you jump immediately.
Did you see that? Nobody
tougher than it needed to be, but it's just that last bit of rocks at the end is the hard part. I believe that's this level done. At least I hope it is. I'll check really quickly. I'll take a look at the atlas and make sure. Shouldn't have looked at this one, because I have to cycle through all of the levels. Honey Speedway, okay, good. So all I gotta do is just redo Lost Fleet. There's nothing I can do for the other level, the Agent 9 level. So, let's see Lost Fleet. We'll head in here again. We'll do the skateboarding challenge, and that will be it. That will be everything that I want to do so far in the game. I'll have done all the backtracking I can do. So we'll just head back along this route, bypassing all of this because we don't need it. Need to worry about any of it. Oops. Crap.
Spyro, you're just in time. A Rhinox skateboard gang has challenged us to a race. They said you're slower than a molten crater fire slug. I stuck up for you, though. I told them I've seen some pretty fast fire slugs. So, are you ready to race these guys? They bet us an egg that you won't win. Right on! You can use my special racing board. Every time you do a trick, it builds up turbocharge. You can use your turbos at any time by pressing the square button. Good luck!
Alright, so do tricks to get turbos. Use turbos by pressing the square, beat all Rhinox in 3 laps. So, what you have to do is just do tricks. That's all you have to do. You don't have to worry about the treasure. We don't have any turbos, so nothing we can do there. It's not letting me do any tricks. There are rockets and speed stars that you can use. So if you don't, if you can't do tricks, you know, you don't have to worry about it. All you have to do is just use speed stars to your advantage. And you have to use a boost to be able to get over there. But, crap. So if you do fall off your board, you will fail. There's a kind of a shortcut there. I don't know why in the world it ain't letting me do any tricks. Yeah, there ain't no way I'm gonna win. So, if you find yourself in this position, I would suggest just try to go after it. Oh. What the? I didn't know I had any boost. Okay. I guess I don't have that much, but alright, so you're gonna have to use your flips and stuff to be able to make it. Ah, that was a waste. Oh, cool, they still give it to you. Are you kidding me? Sadly, they don't give you a boost meter of any kind. Oh wow, I'm actually surprised I made that. To tell you whether or not you know what your boost level is, I definitely don't suggest using a boost after using a speed star. That's probably not a very good idea. Or if you happen to fail a jump, or you know if you don't get a jump high enough, that should be the last lap.
Sheesh. What happened? I could beat these guys with my tail tied behind my back. I hope you do better this time, or we'll never live it down. All right, let them have it.
so I know what to do now. At least how to get tricks anyway. Not necessarily how to beat them, but... Oh, crap, I overshot that. Just a little bit. I guess hitting the crabs will give you extra boost, perhaps. And that is a shortcut on the right there. If you can figure out how to get to it, it will definitely help you out. But it's not worth killing yourself over, or potentially losing. You know, I am in second place right now, so I don't really want to risk that. You can see you can knock the other racers off of their boards just like you. So if you do happen to knock somebody off, that will slow them down. It won't necessarily help you increase your chances of winning, but it will definitely help by quite a bit. So I'll save up some boost and try to use it. I don't want to mess around too much, you know, slow down too much, but I do have the ability to run into them with my board, slow them down, and I also have the rocket that I've been hanging on to, and I'm on the last lap, so I'm kind of okay, at least for the moment. As long as I don't wreck, I should be okay. Just hope they don't challenge me to another race. You should be able to do a triple backflip there, but I won't push it.
Yes! You schooled them like a bunch of dizzy one-toed sand norks. Oh yeah, I guess we won this egg too.
Alrighty. So I wonder what we'll have to do now. Probably another race.
Now that the Rhinox are gone, do you want to try a real challenge? I know you're fast, but I bet you can't defeat all the crabs on the course and still beat me in a race. Want to give it a shot?
Not really. Alright, defeat all the crabs on the course and beat Hunter in 3 laps. So that shouldn't be too difficult. You know, you're just defeating the crabs, but racing Hunter is the hard part. I believe what he will do is he will take the shortcuts. Yeah, you can see he's taking the shortcuts, just like I figured he would. But you have the ability to use the rockets to your advantage. Something that he won't use against you. I shouldn't have done that. Well, there ain't no way I'm gonna win now, but I shouldn't have pushed it like that. But that is definitely a very good shortcut if you can, you know, if you can figure out how to use it to your advantage. It definitely helps. You're supposed to boost in the air while trying to attempt both all of these shortcuts, so I shouldn't be attempting them while, you know, just regularly. I need to be doing it while in the air. Easy jump and then boost, but maybe you need to boost right off the ramp. But yeah, there ain't no way I'm going to win this time, but it's good to practice. You know, you kind of get a feel for where all the crabs are. They do give you boost, not a whole lot, but they do give you a little bit, so, you know, you can use them to your advantage. Again, the rocket's something a Hunter won't use, so just keep that in mind. You can do little tricks off of these little jumps, but remember that will slow you down.
Woohoo! I'm still the speed king of the world.
All right.
this again. Oh, wow. So, really? What the heck was that? Well, there ain't no way I'm gonna win now, but... just boost off the ramp, or while you're going up the ramp, and that should help you get the... and try to jump at the right time as well, and that should allow you to get the enough boost to be able to get it. Yeah, there ain't no way you can see. I can't even see Hunter anymore. So I'm still gonna have to try this again, sadly. But you can see there's a whole upper section up there that's very fast, very good shortcut. So you can just see how good of a shortcut that is, and then if you have the other boost as well, if you're able to do any tricks, very useful. I'm actually surprised I was able to catch up to him. Even a little bit. But yeah, there ain't no way I'm gonna be able to catch him, like I said, this round, or this lap, or this time. Saving that. Yeah, there ain't no way I'm gonna catch him now. Crap. Oh, wow. That was my chance. I'm still in first, but not by a whole lot. Sadly, it doesn't seem like I can knock him off of his board like I could with the Rhinox. So it looks like he doesn't. On the second lap, he doesn't take the shortcuts and stuff. And this is the time when you would want to try to gain a whole bunch of time on him. So he will take this shortcut. But there shouldn't be a crab up here. That's BS. There really shouldn't be a crab right there. Now I don't have any boost on for this shortcut. As long as I don't mess this up, I should have it. At least I hope I will. Oh man, I'm not gonna. I don't think I'm gonna get this because I'm not gonna do the. Surprisingly, I beat it. I don't know how. Just using the rockets definitely helps. You know, trying to boost when he doesn't definitely helps. At least going on one lap along the shortcut definitely helps as well. I still need to get all the treasure that was scattered around. Up here, this piece, anywhere else. Of course, to go along the shortcut, you're going to need to... Oh, so I guess if you ride on the skateboard, you're going to have to stay on the skateboard. That's a shame. and it looks like there's a crab all along the shortcut anyway, so. You're gonna have to take the shortcut anyway, at least one lap. Wonder where the rest of the treasure is. Oh, I know, yeah, I kinda know where. Yeah, right there. Treasure. I'm not gonna worry about that butterfly. It's probably a oh, are you supposed to do a course record? Or if you want to, you can. Well, no, I don't want to. I guess if you beat the course record, that's a... Oh, I really hate to, but I'm gonna give it a shot. I'll at least give it one attempt anyway. Even if that's all I do, I will give it one attempt, because I'm sure that's a skill point. Well, it's always the next lap, and I can always get this. Record this time, but just if you can hit the shortcuts every lap, that should help you. Yeah. Yeah, it's 4 seconds off, but that's fine. I'm sure that's a skill point anyway, but I don't really care. I'm not going after the skill points. But we can exit the area. We completed the level, so. I'm going to exit level, and then I'll just, then that's everything that I wanted to do in this video, so I'm going to talk about the trivia for the two levels that I've done so far, the boss round and the Sparks area. Scorch's Pit. We'll start there. Midnight Mountain is the next level area. Scorch's Pit is home to Scorch, who is the evening leg boss in the game Spyro the Dragon. Scorch must be beaten in order to get to Midnight Mountain. One egg, no fodder. Let's see. knows, the burning smileys are the big thing, you know, the big, like, sun seed things that we're going after. Oh, I guess that just covers back up once you leave. Yeah, that's just the new enemies. No trivia for this particular level. So, we don't have to worry about that. So we'll go to Starfish Reef. Starfish Reef is a Sparks Realm for the home world, Evening Lake in the game Spyro. You're the dragon. Like all Sparks Realms in this game, it can only be accessed when you have defeated the boss of the home world, in this case, Scorch. 200-piece treasure, 1 egg, butterflies. Trivia, this level is considered the hardest Sparks level in the game because of its boss fight. The ability you get afterwards is the monsters look like starfish, eels, and manta rays. The ability that you gain is to have an extra hit point. I will try to find a frog really quickly to demonstrate this. But so instead of 3 hit points, you have 4. And Sparks will glow with a brighter yellow than he is now. You can kind of see he's glowing just a little bit brighter than he normally is. And that will tell you his damage. I'll try to point that out in the next video, but anyways, that's all the trivia and everything, so thank you for watching. The challenge of the video is how many times did I jump while on the skateboard in the skateboarding section of Lost Fate. Thank you for watching. Next time we will go through Midnight Mountain, and we will try to do some of the levels there. Start with some of the levels there and do some of the things there. So until then, later everyone.